Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be going over permission sets in Salesforce. I did this video way back in the beginning of my channel, and since then permission sets have been updated a little bit, and also my setup for filming these videos has improved miles and miles. And before we get into the video about permission sets, I would really love it if you could hit the subscribe button and the like button. I'm currently about 14 subscribers away from hitting that 1,000 mark, and it would mean a lot if you would do that for me. So let's jump into permission sets. A little bit about permission sets. They're used to open up object level security in a one-off scenario for a user or two, or maybe depending on your org, it could, if you have a very large org, it could be like 10 users. So a great example of when you would want to use this rather than create a whole new profile is when you have an org with a sales team and a service team. One of the sales team members is very knowledgeable about the product, and the sales user has been asked to help the service members with a case that involves the product that the sales user is super knowledgeable about. Because of their knowledge. So this would be a one-off scenario where you'd want to create a permission set for that sales user to be able to help on those cases. So let's go ahead and jump into our setup, and then we can go to permission sets. All right, let's go permission sets in the quick find up here. All right, so when you're creating a new permission set, you'll click new. You'll have a label. I'm just gonna have this be new. You'd have session activation required, which means that they have to reactivate their session. You could have it also be a certain license. So you could have it be a permission set for a chatter-free user or for a partner user or for a sales user. I am going to click none and hit save here. All right, and permission sets have loads and loads of different things in them. And we're gonna brush by some of these and just really go to the what I would classify as the three most important parts. So we've got our assigned apps. So that is up here in the 3x3. You can assign apps based upon a permission set. So let's say you had a sales user, they need to see the sales console. And similarly for service users, if you had a service user, you'd want to have them see the service console. So that's where you would go in and assign it based upon their permission set. And remember, these are already in addition to profiles, so their profile might already include this. This is for the one-off scenario to give them access. Assigned connected apps. These are very similar to the assigned apps. And then next we have object settings. This is one of the bigger permissions that you can give. You can give the access to all of these different objects that are in there. So let's go through, and I would like to give access to our cases. So I clicked on cases, and when we go into cases, we'll be able to say, yes, I want them to be able to go into it, which is the tab. So I want it to be available to them. And then what kind of object permissions are they? Read, edit, create, delete, or their CRED. So in the case of the sales user, I want them to read and edit. I don't want them to have create or delete. And then here you'll be able to give either read access or edit access onto specific fields. All right, so now we can click save, and this is for all the different objects that are in the object settings. All right, now I want to go back to this permission set overview. And then we have app permissions, Apex class access, visual force page access, external data source access, flow access. So can you execute flows? This could be really important depending on how complex your org is. Named credential access, data category visibility, custom permissions. So custom permissions, I've used them in the past. So if you have a really, really custom org where you have different things that people need access to that you cannot give via permission set in the typical standard permissions, then you would create custom permission to give access for it. Custom metadata types, custom settings, and then we have system permissions and service providers. I want to go into system permissions. So here is where all of the fun one-off system permissions lie. Whenever I've had a user come to me and say, hey, Emily, there is this permission that I need, but I'm not quite sure how to get it. And then I'm confused because I'm like, well, this isn't really object access. This isn't other access. It must be a system permission. So you have different things like enabling that you can edit dashboards or dashboard folders or edit certain tasks. These would all be here. And oftentimes it just takes a quick Google search of how to give this permission in Salesforce. And oftentimes it'll come up with an answer that it is in this permissions, system permissions. And then you'll be able to give it via a permission set. And this is probably the number one use case I've seen for permission sets is giving these system permissions to a user. All right, so those are system permissions. One thing though, before we move on, is that system permissions are a larger portion that I've noticed on the advanced admin exam. So you'll want to be very familiar with the edit and modify permissions within the system permissions for that exam. And that's all I'll say on that. Before we close out the video, I want to show you how you assign these permission sets. You just go to manage assignments. And then from here, you give it to a specific user. So we can give it to myself, because I'm the only one that has a Salesforce license in this test org. So I'm going to click assign it to myself. And there we go. That is done. We can also remove assignments from here. You can also do it on the user profile. And those are permission sets. I hope this was helpful and a much better quality than my first video on permission sets. Be sure to like and subscribe. It really helps out my channel, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.